मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन इन योर हाउसेस. स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम ऑल्सो फाइन हियर. ओके, वेरी गुड. ओके, शैल वी कम बैक टू आवर लेसन इन सिक्स्थ लेसन इन कॉमर्स, द मनी मार्केट. हियर वी हैव स्टडीड सम ऑफ द मनी मार्केट इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, इज़न्ट इट? द ट्रेजरी बिल्स एंड द सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ डिपॉजिट्स वी हैव लर्न्ड ऑलरेडी. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द कमर्शियल बिल. This commercial papers we have studied, no, that one, because it is like a bill of exchange. Okay, that is why it is given as commercial bills. These bills are we can say it is a bill of exchange. Okay, it is issued by the commercial organization, trading organization or commercial organizations, in order to raise money. Okay. For short-term needs, we already know all the money market instruments are short-term. They will fulfill the short-term needs of the organization only. Okay, these commercial bills are of three kinds: 30 days, 60 days, and 90 days commercial bills. Okay. Then, usually these commercial bills are issued by the seller, okay, by the seller on the buyer, on the buyer of goods. We have studied already, these bills are issued by a commercial organization in order to meet its short term needs. Okay, it is of three kinds: 30 days bill, 60 days bill, and 90 days bill. Usually these commercial bills are issued by the seller of goods on the buyer of goods, because if the goods are sold on credit basis, okay, that is the accepted, they will accept that within 30 days they have to pay back the money. Okay, so what are the features of these commercial bills? We have studied in accountancy last year the bill of exchange, and it's you might not have studied, I think, in the deleted portion. Okay, like a bill of exchange, it has some of the features. First one is, I will explain each and every one. Okay, drawer, that means one who writes the bill. Okay, one who writes the bill is called the drawer, or we can say the seller only will make the bill. So the seller is the drawer. Okay, then acceptor, who has to accept the buyer. He has to accept what is written in the bill, that I will pay the amount mentioned in the bill within 30 days. Okay, so he is the acceptor, or we can say drawee. Okay, drawee also we can say. Then the other person, payee. Here, to whom the amount should be paid. Usually the acceptor has to pay the amount to the drawer. Here, why they have given payee? Sometimes that is another feature. Okay, that is endorser. Here the drawer will be the endorser. He will write and transfer the ownership to another person. Okay, so now the acceptor has to pay the amount to payee. Understood? That is why that payee given. Okay, only they have given that heading, I am explaining that one. Okay, then the fourth one, discounter. What is discount? Discounter is the bank. How? When now the payee needs money immediately. Okay, he is not able to wait for these 30 days or 60 days. He may need of money very urgently. So what he can do, no? He will discount this bill in the bank. So the bank will credit the amount, not full amount. The bank will charge 1% as a discount. Okay, that is why it is called discounter. Now we have studied endorser, that the drawer or the one who makes the bill, one who writes the bill, can transfer the ownership of that bill to another person. That is called payee. Okay, so he is called, drawer is called endorser. Then assessment. Assessment, when the bill has to be paid, it must be assessed. Okay, within many bills will be there. Okay, what all the bills must be honored within this month, so that will be assessed, where that will be calculated. That is called assessment. Then maturity. Maturity of the period. Here they may give that grace days sometimes, because the bills are having the grace days. That means after the maturity of that date's maturity, 30 days means they will count 30 days from the date of writing the bill, and they may add 3 days as grace days. Okay, that day will be the maturity date. Then credit rating. The credit rating, the credit they can raise through issue of this commercial bills. Okay, whether it is high or low. Now we will learn about the types of this commercial bills. Okay, the first one, demand bills. It is one of the 3-mark questions. Okay, these bills, here they do not have a specific time, okay, date of maturity, but whenever and wherever we demand, if you demand to have money, that just you can present it to the drawer. Whenever you need money, you can present that bill and you can collect the money, okay. That is called demand bill. Then clean bill and documentary bill. Clean bill and documentary bill. Here, clean bill do not have any documents. No documents will be attached along with the clean bills. But document bills, along with the bills, some other document of title to the goods. Okay, document of title to goods also will be there along with this. Bills. Okay, that's why it is called document bills. Clean bills, they do not have, that bills may not accompany any documents or documentary bills. Then, inland bills and foreign bills. This inland bills, what are the inland bills? They are drawn and payable in India. Okay, the drawer and payee in India. Okay, inland bills are drawn and payable in India. Okay, that means one who draws the bill or one who writes the bill and one who pays the bill, both will be residing in India. Then what are foreign bills? This foreign bills are drawn outside India. Okay, drawn outside India, it must be drawn outside India, but payable either in India or outside India. Okay, in or out India, that is, they are called foreign bills. They must be drawn outside India, but it may be payable in India or outside India. They are called foreign bills. Then the fourth variety is indigenous bills. Indigenous bills. Here, these bills are they are governed by the customs of the particular place. Custom and usage of trade. Okay, the drawing and acceptance. As per their trade, they can draw any bill. Okay, that is called indigene. The miscellaneous bills, we can say. Okay, not like foreign bill, documentary bill, some other type of bill. Those who can draw and they can withdraw the money, they are called indigenous bills. Now, accommodation bills. Accommodation bills. What are accommodation bills? Here, these bills are not, here the indigenous bills are as per the customs and usage of trade. But this one is not, these bills usually they arise not because of the trade. Okay, for some other activities these bills can be written. They are called accommodation bills. Okay, 5 kinds of bills. Commercial bills we have studied. Okay, now we will learn about the government securities. Government securities, or we can call them as gilt-edged securities. They are called gilt-edged securities also. Okay, government securities are gilt-edged securities. Here, gilt-edged securities market. What is gilt-edged securities market? One simple sentence we can write. The market where the government securities are, the gilt-edged securities are bought and sold. Okay, that is called government securities market or gilt-edged securities market. Now we will learn the characteristics of this government securities market. Characteristics or features. Okay, features of government securities market. It is one of the 5-mark question. Okay, and 2-mark questions also available. Almost the last points. Okay, so they will ask you the agencies, first point. So, you can say the government securities, they are issued by agencies. Okay, now we will see who are these agencies. They may be the central government. Okay, then all state governments in India. Okay, or we can say the semi-government authorities. Semi-government authorities. We can say the local self-government, local government authorities. Okay, that is the panchayat. Okay, municipalities. Then panchayat, then any autonomous institution. Okay, we can say the metropolitan authorities or port trust, all these will come under this, the market, government securities market. Anybody can issue. Okay, so the government securities are issued by agencies such as central government, state governments, semi-government, semi-government authorities like local self-government, then such as municipalities, panchayat, an autonomous institution, then we can say such as metropolitan authorities and port trust, etc. Okay. Then second point, RBI special role. RBI special role. Here, RBI only takes active interest in the purchase and sale of these securities. Okay, who is doing RBI? Reserve Bank of India. It takes a special and active role in the purchase and sale of these securities. So they do this role as a part of its monetary management exercise. Okay, that is so they are purchasing and selling. Who? Especially the RBI, that takes a special role in the purchase and sale of these government securities, because it is a part of its monetary management exercise. Okay, then the third point is nature of securities. So what the securities provide, these government securities? They provide a guaranteed payment of interest. Okay, we purchase these government securities, a fixed rate of interest will be given, either maybe yearly or monthly. Okay, and the repayment of the principal amount, what we have paid, if we have paid 15,000 or 1 lakh amount, if we pay, they will pay monthly that interest, as well as they will monthly or yearly the interest will be paid, as at the same time they will pay back the principal amount also. Okay, that is the nature of the securities. Then fourth one, liquidity profile. Government securities will be having high liquidity profile, isn't it? Liquidity, converting that securities into cash, is highly liquidity. Okay, the central government securities will be having high liquidity profile, okay, than the other government securities. Okay, that will vary because many people issue, the agencies, you know, even local self-government, then municipalities, then that autonomous institution, okay, such as the port trust. Okay, so it will vary, the liquidity profile will vary as per the agencies who issue. But the central government, the first one, the central government securities is having a high liquidity profile. Okay, then the tax rebate. It is a peculiar feature it is having, because if the people purchase the securities, government securities, they are given tax redemption. Okay, they are free from paying tax for them, for that money that they invest in this government securities. Okay, that is why it invite many people to invest their money in this government securities. Okay, tax rebate, they do not need to pay tax for the amount that they spend in this government securities. Then market. So where, which place they purchase and sell these securities, okay, this gilt-edged securities, usually they do in the over-the-counter exchange of India, OTCEI. And again, the stock exchange, okay, even stock exchange also we can use to purchase and sell this securities. They may sell even the stock exchange will be considered as the primary market as well as secondary market. First time also they can issue these securities through stock exchange. Okay, but the company's shares will be issued first by the companies alone, not in the stock exchange. But this government securities or gilt-edged securities may be issued first as primary securities and secondary, primary and secondary in the stock exchange. Okay, then funds. This the securities of this one, central government and state government securities. Okay, these two securities have some forms. They have this, no, it is like what? They ask, it is like what? We can say the inscribed stock. Stock, we say, no, inscribed stock, the fully paid up share is called stock. Or we can say stock certificate. Okay, but someone has the stock certificate issued by the corporation. But we know, because it is in the form of a stock certificate, that is called the gilt-edged securities. Okay, it is in the form of inscribed stock or stock certificate or promissory note. Promissory note, and it is called bearer bond. You can say it as bond also. Okay, promissory note, stock certificate, bearer bond, inscribed stock. It is having different names. Okay, that is called forms. Participants. Who are the participants? We have studied, isn't it? The government. Maybe the central government and state government. Okay, they are the participants. Then trading. Here, not like this trading is done in the stock exchange only, isn't it? In the secondary market. But it is less active only. Okay, very small, this stock exchange. Okay, but still, they purchase and sell the securities in stock exchanges. Okay, in stock exchanges, they purchase and sell this government securities. But it is very less active. Not like the company's shares. Okay, then issue mechanism. Who will issue this bond? The currency notes are issued by the government, no? In the same way. Who is the issue mechanism? Here we know our central bank, the RBI. Okay, RBI, the public debt office of RBI. Public debt office. They are the issuing that the securities, issuing mechanism. Is the issuing mechanism the RBI? Okay, the public debt office. Their own office will be functioning in RBI, that is called public debt office. This office only will issue the securities. Then issue opening. How long it will be opening for the public to purchase? Okay, what they will do? They will give a notification. They will give a notification notice few days before. Okay, before issuing the securities. Or they will say for 3-5 days it will be kept open. That will be given to the public. Okay, that notification in the issue that the mostly circulated newspaper, they will send a notification to the public. Okay, then grooming gradual. What is grooming gradual? Here, you should understand, the RBI will purchase the securities. Okay, who will do this one? The RBI. They will acquire the securities which are nearing maturity. What they will purchase? The security, that maturity period will be nearing. That maturity nearing securities, they will purchase. Why they are purchasing? In order to facilitate the redemption of other securities. What is the meaning? Redemption means they have to repay the securities once the period gets matured, isn't it? 30 days or maybe 1 year. Okay, so they do not have money, So what they will do, the RBI, again they will purchase the nearing maturity nearing securities, they will purchase and they will get that amount within 10 days. That amount will be used to repay the matured securities. Okay, that is called grooming gradual acquisition of securities nearing maturity through the, how they do, through the stock exchange. Okay, by the RBI in order to facilitate redemption is described as grooming gradual, gradual grooming. Okay, then 13th one, switching. This you have to listen carefully. Okay, what is switching? Here also it is like somewhat nearing this grooming gradual. Okay, here they will purchase one security on the sale of another security. Okay, first they will sell one security. Okay, they will, at the sale of security, they will purchase some other security. This is also carried out by RBI, where it is done in the secondary market. Secondary market means stock exchange. Okay, it is done by RBI. This is its open market operations. As its open market operation, that is called as switching. Okay, purchase of one security against the sale of another security carried out by RBI in the secondary market, it's part of open market operation. Okay, that is called switching. Okay, then the 14th one is auctioning. We know, isn't it? It is a method of trading whereby many merchants will be there. They will call out their price. They will bid on another. Okay, the price. Then at last the security will be given to the highest bidder. One who has called for the highest value. Okay, he is called the highest bidder to whom it is given after saying 1, 2, 3. Okay, that is called auction. This is also done in the government securities market. Okay, for the government securities. Trading, method of trading whereby the merchants bid against one another and where the securities are sold to the highest bidder is known as auctioning. Okay, students, you might have understood. I will send you the pages. You learn. I will show you that one in the, I will just show the book also how we have marked. I will send the question page also. Okay. You see, these features of commercial bill. Okay. Roman number 4, 4. Then types of commercial bills. Okay, commercial bills, then government securities market, that is question 2 mark. Then the characteristic, it is the 5th question in 5 mark. Okay, then the full page, all the points. Okay, 10 points again. Here 4 points. Okay, here again you see switching is 5th question 2 mark. Here 4th question 2 mark. Okay, auction. Okay, students, so you better study these question answers. Okay, thank you very much.